Mitch Van Cleve is a junior who is involved in NHS, plays soccer, is a section leader for the percussion section in band, and on the weekends he drives to Des Moines, Iowa for Crossroad Percussion.
Crossroads Percussion is an independent WGI percussion group based out of Des Moines. This is their third year as a program. It's mostly college kids, as are most WGIs. What a WGI is it's an organization that pretty much like a band. It's just a professional band that a lot of college people perform in, and you go and perform against other bands and compete. DCI is more of the summer with the whole band thing, whereas WGI, what I'm doing right now, is during the winter, it's just percussion. So we're all indoor in a gym, just drums for 7 minutes. I knew that I wanted to take a step up, and it's always kind of something that I've wanted to do. Basically, it was this year I decided I was gonna do it, and I looked online for like different cores and stuff that were around here. I looked at one in St. Louis that wasn't my favorite, and then I actually have friends and people that I know in Des Moines, and so I went up there to audition, and I really liked the atmosphere. And yeah, it's a fun thing, and I'm very glad that I'm doing it. I have to stay pretty organized. I mean, I'm in Des Moines every single weekend, you know, and I have been since December, and I will be until April. I just have to stay prioritized, you know. I talk to my teachers, make sure if I'm gonna miss a day where I have to like leave early to go to Des Moines or something, I just clear everything up with them of like what we're gonna do that day. I have to make sure I have all my stuff done. I don't want WGI to be like an excuse for me not to do my work. I just wanna get all of my stuff done and pretty much have all of that done so that I can do WGI on top of it.
So who were some standouts today?
Just to name a few, we had, first of all, Braden Booth placed first in ag business, and not only first in our district, but first in the entire state. We had Ms. Madeline Barker, who placed first in job interview, and then we also had Mr. Christian Allen, who placed first in intro to business at districts.
On stage, your winners, introduction and public speaking. In third place, from Fair Grove, Alex Cadence. From Fairgrove, Lucas Crutcher. In second place, Christian Allen. And on stage, your winners from Management Decision Making. In fifth place, from Fairgrove, Preston Coffinbutel. In fourth place, from Fairgrove, Tyler Padgett. Stage winners from Local Business. In second place, from Fairgrove, David Oblotnick and Travis Ronald. Now on stage, your winners from Marketing. Third place, from Fairgrove, Madeline Barker and Abigail Gilmore. Now on stage, your winners from Organizational Leadership. In fifth place, from Fairgrove, Lana Hall.
Yeah!
Personal Finance. In fifth place, Fairgrove, Madeline Barker. Now on stage, your winners for Impromptu Speaking. In second place, Fairgrove, Braden Booth. On stage now, your winners for Sales Presentation. In third place, from Fairgrove, Travis Renoff. Now on stage, your winners for Introduction to Business. Your winner from Fairgrove, Christian Allen. Stage your winners for Introduction to Financial Math. In fifth place, from Fairgrove, Abigail Gilmore. On stage, your winners from Job Interview. And your winner from Fairgrove, Madeline Barker. 2020 Sweepstakes Awards go to, in fifth place, Fairgrove.
Valentine's Day, and here at Fairgrove, love is in the air. Let's examine the romance the students have to offer. Grayson, what are you doing for Valentine's Day?
I'm going to hang out with my Valentine.
Taylor. What do you plan on doing for Valentine's Day with your significant other?
I have a basketball game the same day, but I mean, probably take her out to dinner maybe.
That'll be very nice. Where do you want to go to dinner?
Wherever she wants to.
Very smart man. All right, guys, I'm here with Miracle. And Miracle, what does Valentine's Day mean to you?
Nothing. Absolutely nothing.
What about your significant other? Girl, it's that time
of year. Got some roses. I don't know.
Uh-oh. All right, guys, I am here with Landon, and I am here with Dakota. What is your guys' favorite candy? Let's go with Dakota.
Those little hearts that you get from Walmart.
What color?
The fake ones.
Okay, nice. And Landon, what is yours?
My favorite one is those little blow pops that you get bubble gum out of. That way you can blow bubbles.
What flavor?
All of them.
All of them? Nice.
Over the weekend in Springfield, there was a circus protest. Let's hear what one of the protesters have to say.
It's important for us to protest because we have to be out here to stand up for these animals. You know, the wild animals in there are being exploited, they're being abused so that people can have some cheap form of entertainment. These animals are wild animals. They're elephants, tigers, and camels that are being whipped and the bull hooks being used on them so that people can have, you know, an hour of entertainment, but it's a lifetime of misery for them.
But not many agree with the protesters.
Well, I wish that they weren't here. And there's all kinds of inspections that go on inside, and they make sure that the animals are healthy, that they're fed, you know, that they're safe. And so there really is no reason for them to even be here.
Regardless of your opinions about the circus, it's still a family fun activity, whether you're protesting or watching the show.
Students at our school are working very hard to prepare themselves for life after high school. Some students are choosing to take part in programs that school offers.
GoCaps and OTC offer different types of technical schools for high schoolers. GoCaps has 6 different branches of study at different locations. It is similar to OTC. It offers classes during the school day that prepares the students to an area that they are interested in.
So Maddie, what benefits does GoCaps give you?
Well, GoCaps gives us the opportunity to go out into the career field and do job shadows, make relationships with professionals, and get involved in the workforce.
That's great. So why did you sign up for GoCaps?
Well, those few things were the main reasons that I signed up, and my career interest actually falls into the categories that the medical strand covers.
So what does GoCaps prepare you for?
GoCaps prepares you for a career in professional anything. Like, ours, of course, is medical, but there's so many other strands, engineering, IT, teaching. It's just preparing you for a professional career later on.
And what does this program offer that others don't?
You could be hands-on. You do job shadows in the medical field. You go to presentations. You do professionalism panels. So you get really involved and hands-on rather than just watching presentations and taking a class.
So at OTC, we focus on electronic media production. That's the program I'm in. And we do a lot with cameras, take pictures, Photoshop, video editing, which includes Premiere. We have sound design. We do like radio commercials and music and stuff like that. And then we have newscast, and we make storyboards for local news stations and stuff like that. And then here I take government and geography, investigative bio, and English too.
This year, more students are taking more consideration of life after high school and preparing for it.
Many different programs are offered to the students to help them give a head start in the work industry. OTC, for example, offers hands-on courses for specific jobs and gives students high school and sometimes college credit.
OTC and GoCaps are hands-on programs with different strands or majors to choose from. Yo, VIP. Let's kick